National Youth Commission Chair Ronald Gardema summoned for a preliminary investigation in relation to complaints filed by P3 PWD representative Rowena Guanzon. Jervis Manahan now joins us for more details. Jervis.
Yes, Ron, the squabble between National Youth Commission Chairman Ronald Gardema and former COMELEC Commissioner Rowena Guanzon continues as the Quezon City Prosecutor's Office issued a subpoena to Gardema for cases filed by Guanzon. The former COMELEC Commissioner filed cyber libel and unjust vexation cases against Gardema last June 21. The subpoena orders Gardema to appear for a preliminary investigation on August 4 and 11. Guanzon says Gardema must study law to save on legal fees as cases against him are piling up. The P3 PWD party list representative also said Gardema must learn the lesson that he cannot shoot his mouth off and not face legal consequences. Meanwhile, Gardema seemed to just confidently shrug it off. He said it was them who should be filing cases against Guanzon, as he cited other instances where the former commissioner made allegedly libelous statements against certain personalities. Apart from the complaint in the Quezon City Prosecutor's Office, Guanzon has also filed complaints against Gardema before the Ombudsman due to alleged violations of ethical practices for public officials. Ron.
That report from Jervis Manahan. Thank you very much, Jervis.
Bulatlat's associate editor Danilo Arau slams the court decision denying their appeal, which sought to unblock its website. He says that move by the National Telecommunications Commission should not have been implemented in the first place. He asserts the website is inaccessible for most people. Otto says it just proves there is suppression.
I don't need to know what device you're using or the browser that you're using. That's part of your privacy. But the bottom line here is there are people like you and me who are able or unable to access the website. So just because the defendants were able to do so at that particular time and for whatever settings they may have implemented, we don't know for a fact whether or not they have VPN or they have adjusted the domain name server settings. We don't know that for a fact. There are ways to bypass DNS blocking. But the fundamental question here is, should that order be imposed on the internet service providers in the first place?
The Marcos administration urged to streamline the process of getting housing projects approved. The Habitat for Humanity points out, over 6 million Filipino families are in need of quality housing. It also calls for cooperation among various sectors to help build more houses in the Philippines.
The collective effort we need is to work with DSHUD, with the mayors and local government units, with the developers and with the other NGOs to streamline that process. There's 60 steps to get a project approved right now. If we could reduce that to 10 steps, think how much faster we could build. And that takes cost out if we take time out.
The Highway Patrol Group and the Metro Manila Development Authority say marked government vehicles can use sirens and blinkers if they are in the middle of an emergency or operation. MMDA Director Baltazar Melgar notes they have issued a memo to their employees on when to use blinkers. This comes after some senators called out the use of these warning systems by so-called VIPs to avoid traffic.
Halimbawa, sa amin din eh, pagka meron kaming may na-aksidente doon, halimbawa na kailangan naming puntahan kagad namin yung mga enforcer. So, kailangan nilang gamitin yung kanilang sirena siguro, parang ganon. Ganon din sa ibang ahinsya, kung mayroon silang emergency,